Almaty was full of excitement today as day 9 of competition continued on. The sun was shining and 9 different sports took to the snow or ice. We'll check in with women's alpine skiing slalom, men's cross-country relay, and both men's and women's 500-meter short track speed skating. Then we'll head over to the ice hockey to see all the highlights of the women's bronze medal game between the People's Republic of China and the United States of America. Plus, we couldn't miss the women's curling bronze medal game as well between Sweden and Switzerland. Shimbuloq Ski Resort was a stunning venue today for the women's alpine skiing slalom event. Let's check in with the first run here. Here's Sweden's Louise Jansson. Here she goes around the markers, blue and red. She would not have the best first run that she could possibly have here. She's going to end with over 45 seconds. Here she is now approaching the finish line. She will end with a time of 45.87 seconds. Up next is Germany's Monika Hübner. Hübner now approaching the finish line. Great race for her, 45.03 seconds. That puts her in the first position spot. Let's watch Maria Shkinova now of Belarus. She got the silver in the alpine combined, the bronze in the giant slalom. Now she is looking to get her third medal at this Universiad. She's coming down the hill now with a spectacular time. This Belarus athlete would end 45.41 seconds, moving her to that second position spot now. Finland's Nia Lukko would have an almost perfect race here. She goes down, you can watch her around each of the markers. She's gonna finish the first run in the third place spot. Close to the end now. Lukko passing the finish line, 45.64 seconds. She moves there once again to that third place. You can see Germany in first, Belarus second, and Lukko in that third after the first run. Let's move now to the second run. Louise Jansson will start off at 45.87 seconds, and her time will be the two combined. Jansson finished the first run in seventh place. She will need to have an almost perfect second run to claim any medal. As she approaches the finish line here, she will end with a time of 1 minute 32.8 seconds. That moves her to the number one spot here. Watch this ending. Just carves around both these last markers. Up next now is Finland's Nia Lukko. Just to remind you, she ended that first run in third place. She will just need to stay on track here to claim that bronze medal or go faster to claim the silver or the gold. You can see her here now approaching the end. Her time against Jansson's, she will end with 1 minute 33.56 seconds, moving her now into that fourth place spot. Moving on, Shkinova, she finished that first run in second place. Again, a two-time medalist at this Universiad. She's gonna wanna go as fast as she possibly can here. She wants her third medal. You can see now Shkinova's time compared to Jansson's time, who's now sitting at the first place position, beating it by 0.27 seconds so far. She's approaching the end. She finishes with an impressive 1 minute 32.57 seconds. Monika Hübner is now up. She finished that first run in first place, so she just needs to stay on par to claim a medal in this event. She goes around every marker with incredible precision here. You can see her time now compared to Shkinova, who's sitting in that first place. Approaching the end, it's going to be a close one. 1 minute, 32.67 seconds, just 0.1 second different. In the end, it was Belarus who took the gold, Germany would take the silver, and Sweden would claim that bronze medal spot. From alpine skiing over to cross-country skiing now, we are at Alito Cross-Country Skiing and Biathlon Complex for the men's 4x7.5 kilometer relay race. Competing today are teams from Russia, Kazakhstan, the Czech Republic, France, Japan, the Ukraine, Norway, and Poland. You can watch the mass start here. You're looking at the Czech Republic right now. Here they go. Kilometers now into the race. Kazakhstan's Malyshev takes a quick lead, followed by Russian's Berezin. It will stay that way here, followed closely behind by Ukraine, but it would be Russia's Berezin who would take a quick lead early on in this first leg. The first exchange here. Kazakhstan leading the way, then the Ukraine, followed closely by the Russian Federation. Minutes now into the race. All the athletes pretty close here. You can get a good glimpse of them all. 2.5 kilometers into this second leg. Just under 23 minutes, it would be Russia that would pull away. They take the lead here, followed by Kazakhstan. It's close, but it won't be for very long. The lead goes back and forth between Kazakhstan's Pukula and Russia's Gonter until the very end of this one. Watch them battle it out for that top spot. The Czech Republic not far behind, and Japan is in there too, followed by Belarus. And at the end, that's the Ukraine. Pukula still in the lead. Gunter not far behind. Japan right on the Russians' tails. Just under 31 minutes now into this one. Gunter still in the lead, but he will get an even bigger lead here, you can see, as he goes into that second exchange of this relay race. Team Russia getting a big head start heading into the third leg of this race. Vichuzanin gets going here. Kazakhstan not far behind, but Mukin gonna have to wait for his teammate to get up. Minutes into this race right now, Russia still has a slight lead over Kazakhstan. You can see here Vichuzanin going right before Mukin for Kazakhstan. 2.5 kilometers left in this third leg. These two athletes would go head to head for the rest of the race. They're coming up now to the third and final exchange in this relay. Kazakhstan just a slight lead now over Russia as they head on to the final stretch. Five kilometers into this final one now, Kazakhstan's Klimin is leading the way over the Russian. A little over an hour into this race now, it is still neck and neck between Team Kazakhstan and Team Russia. Here they are heading into the finish line now. Russia needs to catch up if they're going to take this one. He goes right in front of this Kazakhstan athlete with a huge burst of energy. He's giving it 110% right now, heading into that finish line, and he is going to take it with a time of 1 hour, 12 minutes, 49.3 seconds. Kazakhstan not far behind, 1 hour, 12 minutes, 51.1 seconds. They get the silver. You're watching now. Czech Republic claim that bronze medal. Look how happy he is with his race. Japan not far behind him, but they will claim the fourth place finish. The Czech Republic ends this one with a time of 1 hour, 14 minutes, 51.8 seconds, and Japan 2 minutes and 3.6 seconds behind that Russian team. You can see them here grabbing their gold medal. All of the athletes would receive their medals directly after the event. We head inside now to Balinshcholak Short Track Arena, where both men and women will compete in the 500-meter speed skating event. The athletes come from Korea, Kazakhstan, China, and Japan. First up, we will watch the women's 500-meter event here with athletes from China, Korea, and Japan. You can see here the Chinese athlete Yizi Zhang and Ayla Xu, as well as Korea's athlete Lang Kim and Moemi Kikuchi. This race lasts about 45 seconds. As you can see here, Zhang goes out to an early lead. It's both Chinese athletes leading the way right now, followed by the Korean, and in the end is the Japanese athlete. Three laps to go here. They're going all about 45 kilometers an hour as we head into the 25-second mark of this race. China's Zhang still in the lead. Coming into the final lap here, Zhang took that lead early on and never gave it up this entire race. Still, both Chinese athletes right at the beginning as they cross the finish line. It goes China, China, Korea, Japan. You can see here that early lead that Zhang gets right from the start of the race, and she would never let go. She would end with a time of 44.015 seconds, the next runner-up 44.124. Next up are the men. They come from Kazakhstan, Korea, and China for this one. Here's Kazakhstan's Denis Nikisha, Korea's Do-Kum Kim, China's Guan Chen, another Korean athlete here, Hyo-Jung Lim, and another for Kazakhstan. This one's Abzal Azgaliev. This race was an exciting one. Two players out quickly. Kazakhstan's Denis Nikisha and Korea's Hyo-Jung Lim. China's Chang takes a quick lead on this one with three laps to go. These athletes going just under 50 kilometers an hour. The Korean athlete here, Kim, goes into second place, turning this corner, and during the last lap, this is when he takes that first position spot. China after him, Kazakhstan not far behind now. Coming up to the finish line, it's gonna be Kim who takes the first place position. You can tell he's very happy with this one, and he should be, ending with a time of 41.175 seconds. Let's take another look at this action here, where one athlete from Kazakhstan and one from Korea took a bit of a tumble. Not a good start for these two. China's Chang, you can see there in the red, he takes the lead here, but he will be awarded a penalty. So it is going to be one of these athletes that took a tumble that will move up to third place. Look at Korea here, still going to take that first place position, and two Kazakhstan athletes will move up to the second and third positions here in this race. Both the women and the men received their medals right after this one. Here's China's Zhang getting her gold medal. Again, she finished with a time of 42.335 seconds. Here's the gold, silver, and bronze medalists here for the women. The men now will receive their titles. This is Korea's Kim. He ended with a time of 41.175. And now the two Kazakhstan athletes join him on the podium. A couple pictures and a couple selfies later, the 500-meter event has come to an end. Welcome now to Almaty Arena for the bronze medal curling match between Sweden and Switzerland. Coming into this match, Sweden has a record of 7-3 from the preliminary round, and Switzerland, they are 8-3 coming into this one. During the semifinals, Sweden lost to Canada 7-4, and on the other end, Switzerland, they lost to Russia 8-7. Here's Sweden now in the third end. The first two were draws, 0-0 is the score. It remains now here. Sweden has got three stones in the rock. Switzerland now has the last throw of the third end, trying to knock one of those out. They make contact, but it doesn't go far enough. Sweden would end this one with 3 points. Sweden leads the way after the third end, 3-0. They're up again here. You can see Rana throwing that last stone of the fourth. Her teammates here, some vigorous sweeping. They're gonna wanna get it in there into that 12 foot. They get it into the eighth. They now have 5 stones in the button. Switzerland looking to knock one of these out or get them closer. And although Sweden had more rocks in the target, it would be Switzerland who would pick up the point in the fourth end. The fifth end was another draw, so we're moving now on to the sixth. You're watching Switzerland here with their last throw in the sixth end, get it right into that 12-foot ring. Sweden now, they have a game accuracy of 80% as Rana throws that last rock. Some serious sweeping action there. They will take the point in this sixth end. It is now 4-1 for Sweden. Here's Rana once again in the seventh end, throws that last rock of the end. You can see some serious concentration here. They're gonna wanna get this one into the target if they're gonna get the point at the end of it. But it was Switzerland's turn to knock it out. This one's coming in speedy, knocks two of Sweden's rocks right out. They pick up the point in the fourth now. Their total moves to 2. Switzerland up once again, the last throw of the eighth end. Another speedy one knocks it right out as Sweden tries to get theirs a little bit further. It was their turn now, the last one of the eighth. This one coming in a little bit slower, but doing its job closest to the middle there. They pick up one more point. At the end of the eighth, Sweden leads the way 5-2 over Switzerland. These two teams matched up in the preliminary round with Switzerland beating Sweden 7-6. You can see the last stone here for this team. Now it's Switzerland up. They just got to get this one closer than those three that you're seeing in the red. Judges are going to have to get out, see exactly how close and how far these rocks are from each other. And Switzerland, it would be just centimeters closer. They would pick up that point in the ninth end now, 5-3 for Sweden. In the last and final end, Switzerland would have to make a big comeback to tie or win this game. They've got two rocks in there. So Sweden just has to knock one of them out and get it closer than the other. Here's Rana's last throw of the game, a speedy one. Once again, they take it, knock both out, and grab one more point at the end of this one. The score is 6-3 for Sweden over Switzerland. Sweden now grabs that gold medal in the women's curling event. Last but not least, welcome to Ballon-Sholbach Arena, where the bronze medal women's ice hockey game will take place between the USA and China. Coming into this one, China is 2-2 after losing to Canada and Russia and beating Kazakhstan and Great Britain. The USA is 1-2 heading into this one with a victory over Japan and losses to Canada and Russia. Here's head coach of China, Xiaobo Guan, and for the USA, Shelley Looney. After playing their semifinal matches 2 days ago, both teams are ready to get the action started here at the bronze medal matchup. USA would take the first possession of this one, but it would go back and forth for the entire period. First shot on net here. USA's Rachel Booth gets it up, but stopped by the Chinese goalie. Watch this one again as Booth is able to get it past the defender, but Xia He of China puts her glove right on top. Here's a slap shot once again by Kathleen Ash of the USA. Watch this one. He right into her glove. Next up, Rachel Booth was at it again, but he unstoppable in this first period. Later on, China got some action as well as Xin He took a shot on net. That one wouldn't go either. USA's Amber Green stops it. Look at that, right into her chest, goes down. That would end the first period. Neither team scores in the first. Moving on to the second period now. USA gets another shot on net. That one by Nicole Matthews. Let's watch this one again. From deep, she slings it back. He able to get right in front of it. Watch it again here. A great stop by the Chinese goalie. The coach not quite happy with that one. China on their own though gets another shot attempt. Here's Xin He once again. Fakes out the first one, gets a second one, but Amber Green stops it. The USA wouldn't stop here. Here's Kathleen Ash with another shot on net. Watch this one. He was almost unstoppable tonight in the goal for China. Here's Cassandra Dunn now, trying to fling it back to her teammate, but it's stopped by Zhenwing Zhu. Zhenwing Zhu shoots it off of the pad of Amber Green, and then another shot by Meng Ying Zhang. Look at this one, right off the pad, another shot and another save by the goalie. China wouldn't stop on the offensive now. Here's Xin Yi, another shot on net. This one, right off that top bar, you can almost hear it. Pings right off of that one. Close, but no cigar. A lucky one for goalie Amber Green at the end of the second. The score is still 0-0 in this bronze medal matchup. But in the third, the USA would go on a crazy hot streak. You can see Kendra Myers here right past the right glove of this Chinese goalie. That's going to put USA up 1-0, and they are happy about it. But the action wouldn't stop there. Leah MacArthur now for the USA finds herself open right through the five hole of the goalie. Watch this one again. Catches the puck up top, slings it back. Make that 2-0 now, USA over China. And like I said, the USA was not done scoring in this third period. From deep, Madeline Wolzman chucks one in. Let's see this one once again. Almost from the blue line there. Slings it in. The same spot as that first goal. Right past the right glove of the goalie. Make it now 3-0 USA. Kathleen Ash wanted in on the action. She would get a great shot off at the end of the third. It would be no good, though, and USA would end this one 3-0. They take home the bronze at the 2017 Winter Universiade.